prime time on the Prime Sports Radio Network. I thought I'd let that settle in for just a moment and let you drink it all in for a few moments. Jim Drucker proving that rock and roll in football works, rock and roll in sports radio works. Prime time, coast to coast, Prime Sports Radio Network. I'm Ed Berliner, and this is the Press Box. As the fastest hour in sports comes to you live from Doc Graham's Tap Room and Eatery, just north of Homestead, just south of Miami, Florida, where it has been blistering hot the last couple of weeks, and we are managing to keep our sanity and managing to keep ourselves together. Coming up a little bit later on, Dennis Potvin joins us as we check out the National Hockey League playoffs from Fox Television, also from the Florida Panthers Television and Radio Network. Larry Bluestein will stop by in a couple of minutes as well, and he'll check out what's happening in National High School with our weekly Prep Page segment. Once again, a reminder, I want to tell all our listeners across the country, there are a couple of easy ways to get a hold of us here at the Press Box. One of them that we recommend is via cyberspace, via email, on both Prodigy and on the CompuServe networks. If you want to get a hold of us on Prodigy, it's HFBC02A. That's HFBC02A. You can also access us via the World Wide Web and via the Internet. You can drop down to Prodigy and you can drop us a line there. If it's on CompuServe, it's 76766-3262. That's 76766-3262. And we invite you to join us, drop us a line from time to time and tell us how we're doing here at the Press Box and tell us what we are not doing that you are desperate to hear. Although I can hardly find any room to believe that there's anything we're not doing that you haven't found time to hear right here on the Press Box. Boston, Massachusetts was a scene earlier this week of what can best be described, I guess, as a bloody Monday or a bloody Tuesday. The way within just a couple of hours, the sports fans in Boston, Massachusetts found themselves looking for two brand new head coaches. Because in one bold stroke within a couple of hours of one another, the coaches were gone from both the Boston Celtics and from the Boston Bruins. With the Celtics, Chris Ford was the coach of the Celtics. No longer, he is gone, especially after losing in the playoffs. The Celtics had decided enough was enough. Now, the question, of course, to Chris Ford, was he upset at gathering and getting the news of his firing after being told about it from a reporter?
I was not happy about that. I don't think anyone who is going to be released should hear it first from a reporter or from another source. I think that common courtesy is to look your employee in the face and tell them either they're going to be staying or leaving.
Apparently the Boston Celtics couldn't do that with Chris Ford. He had to find out from a reporter that he had been fired as the head coach of the Boston Celtics. And then there's Brian Sutter, just a couple of hours within Chris Ford's firing. Matter of fact, Ford came first during the day. Sutter came second. And talking to a lot of hockey people that I know, they're rather upset that Sutter got fired because they feel he really didn't deserve it. What about his plans for coaching now in the future?
I don't really know. You guys asked me the other day what I was going to do tomorrow, and I said I didn't know what I was going to do tonight, and I drank a jug of whiskey and just sat back, and I wish I was back in the farm right now and I could get on a horse and go someplace to hear myself so quiet I could hear myself think, but I don't really know right now. I owe my family some things. That's one thing about the lockout. Taught me a lot.
It taught him a lot, but apparently it didn't teach the Boston Celtics enough. I'm waiting to find out now if we can get some communication from our guys back at the studio in Miami. We were scheduled to have a guest on from Boston, Massachusetts, and no one has told me if he's there or not. Apparently I'm told that he is. From our affiliate in Boston, WBPS 890 AM, from the morning show, Rico Petrocelli joins us on the Press Box. Rico, how have you been?
Ed, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Oh, pretty good. There's been some, as they say, another Boston massacre here in the area with the firing of Bruins coach Brian Sutter and Celtics coach Chris Ford. Jason and Freddie were in town chopping some heads off.
Hey, Rico, the couple of minutes that we got, unfortunately, we're a little tight on time here right now because we had a phone delay in getting in touch with you. But let me ask you quickly, with the firings now of Ford and Sutter, is there a thinking as to who they're going to bring in next? Because these two guys were pretty highly thought of in their professions, and you got to wonder who they're going to bring in who supposedly is better.
Well, very much so. There's talk, of course, in the paper, speculation. Steve Casper, who was at Providence with the Providence Bruins, had a very good year this year, talking about the possibility of him coming in. And also, Tommy McVie, the assistant coach, who's done a good job. The players really respect him. He's from the old school, a hard-nosed guy, but he's very close with the players. Also, Jack Parker. Jack was the BU coach this year, won the NCAA championships in hockey, and there's talk about him. But even Mike Milbury, which I doubt very much if he'll come back as far as the hockey scene is concerned. Basketball, all kinds of talk about possibly Don Nelson, Dave Cowens, John Calipari, even ML Carr himself, maybe going out of getting out of the front office and going back on the floor, which I doubt very much too. But I think the guy who has the is first, I think, is Paul Silas, who has the upper hand here. That's what the rumors are, anyway.
I only got about a minute left here, and I tell you what, Rico, because of the problems we had getting in touch with you, I want to have you on the show again, hopefully next week, and we can discuss this a little more in detail.
All right, great.
Yeah, you know, when you're on the press box, Rico, life is good. learn that now. I got to be on the morning show on BPS now to go ahead and return his favor. I got to try that one.
We want to have you on. In fact, right. What time do you get up? We get up at around 3 or 4 o'clock. Get ready for the show and go on a sit.
I'm in the gym at 7 o'clock every morning.
Oh, okay, that's great. We'd love to have you on it.
So I can hit you afterwards. Listen, about the minute we have left, in your opinion, Rico, were these firings deserved?
Well, I don't think any firing is really deserved unless the coach is really a blatant idiot. I think Brian Sutter was a very good coach. They're claiming he was too intense. Can you believe that? With the talk about players not being intense enough these days, Brian took a lot of heat for getting on the players. Of course, the big key for him was the losing in that the round to New Jersey. The team gave up, according to Harry Sinden, and that was it for Sutter. Celtics' Chris Ford is actually relieved at his firing. It was in the cards. There was rumors going on throughout the year about him getting fired, and finally it's happened. So Chris will get a job. He's very well respected in the NBA.
Matter of fact, I think there's an open job in Miami. Gee, how convenient that is.
There's talk about that, too, for Chris.
I'll lay you right now 3-1 that he gets the job in Miami.
Yeah, I think you're right. That's why he's relieved. I think he has talked to somebody already.
I think so, too. Hey, Rico, listen, I'm sorry we only had a couple of minutes here, but I tell you what, we'll get you on the show sometime next week. We'll talk a little bit more about what's going on in Boston.
Okay.
And also, let's go ahead and work it out that some morning I'll come on the morning show with you and the guys on WBPS.
Hey, that'd be great. Stu Taylor, look forward to it also. Take care.
Anytime. Have a good weekend, Rico.
All right, bye-bye.
Rico Petrocelli joining us from our Prime Sports Radio affiliate in Boston, WBPS 890 AM, the morning show there heard in Boston, Massachusetts. See, we're good guys. We help the affiliates. Damn right we do. Coast to coast, prime time on the Prime Sports Radio Network. Ed Berliner's Press Box, the fastest hour in sports. We'll continue from Doc Graham's in Miami.
Statistics prove that there is no such thing as a good or a bad memory, just a trained or an untrained memory. You virtually remember.